Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Chepstow Racecourse here on Thursday. It is December the 27th, 2018. Going to look at the stakes races on today's program from Chepstow. But before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKit5 for more selections for racecourses around the world. So we're going to look at the stakes races, the third race and the featured fifth race, which is the Welsh Grand National, so the 135 and the 250. So let's get on to it. The 135, the third race from Chepstow. It's the Grade 1 Coral Finale Juvenile Hurdle, Grade 1 race class 1 horses, going for a purse of $88,000. Races for juvenile 3-year-olds, field of 5 horses, going 3,200 meters or about 2 miles over the hurdle course. Top selection here, I like the 1 horse Adejali. I'm going to go 1-4-5 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 1-4-5 Tri-Cash Trifecta. Top selection, 1 horse Adejali. 3-year-old colt by Comption here. Daryl Jacob picks up the mount for Nicky Henderson. The horse's most recent outing, first start in the UK, first start in the care of Nicky Henderson, not hurdles, but that came at Market Race in the 6th of December, 2 miles and 1/8 in a class for a juvenile hurdle. The horse did everything right there, won by 13 lengths, Baker's Dozen, jumped well, and just destroyed the field. It was a very good race. I think coming to graded company for the first time shouldn't be a problem, because, you know, his races over the hurdles have been very nicely run, but that December the 6th race was his first race since the 20th of May. That came in France at Auteuil, 2 miles and 1/8 in a listed hurdle. The horse finished third by 5 lengths, and he jumped well, but Auteuil is a very difficult place to get around, but he showed some heart there by staying. It wasn't the world's worst race for him. And then the 26th of April, Compiègne, 2 miles in a juvenile hurdle. He won by 4 lengths, and he just destroyed the field. A very easy race. And then Auteuil on the 7th of April, 1 mile 7/8 in a juvenile hurdle. First outing ever. He jumped very well. And a second by 1 3/4 lengths. A little extra ground should have helped, but, you know, he got it in his debut. He ran well. I like him a lot here today to the step up to graded company, and I think he's had the most impressive races out of all of them, and I think those Auteuil races have put some body into this horse. It builds the foundation. So watch out for this horse here today, excuse me. So to recap my selection for the third, the 135 from Chepstow, the Grade 1 Coral Finale Juvenile Hurdle. Gonna go with the 1 horse Adejali. I'm gonna go 1-4-5 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta to race number 5 now, the Feature 250 from Chepstow. And the last few years, it seems like this fixture always gets canceled because of rain. This year, I think it's the first time since like 2015-16 maybe that they're running it in its scheduled day right after Boxing Day. The last few years it seems like it's been run like the first week of January. I think a few years ago it was run like the second week of January with all the rain they had in Wales. But this year the ground going is soft, which is a major improvement off the last few years where it's run on a sludgy, sloppy, heavy ground. So we're finally gonna get this race in, but hopefully. But the fifth race, the 250 from Chepstow, it's the Grade 3 Welsh Grand National Handicap Chase, Grade 3 race for class 1 horses, going for a purse of $202,500. Race for 4-year-olds and upwards, field of 20 horses, tackling the 3 miles and 11/16 over the chase course. So it's about 3 miles and 5.5 furlongs, 3 miles, 5 furlongs. Top selection here. I'm going to give you 2 horses I think can win. It's a very wide open race, and I'll probably put both these horses in an exacta box or a forecast box. The 2 horses I'll use here is the 3 horse Elegant Escape and the 5 horse Vintage Cloud. So I'll do a 3-5 exacta box, forecast box. And depending on the odds at post time, I might do a small each way on both of them, but that depends on the odds right now. Right now, Elegant Escape, last I saw, he's trading in the UK markets at 5-1. He'll have to go to 8-1 for me to really put a good each way wager on him. But right now I think Vintage Clouds, he's third choice at 9-1. I'll probably do a small each way wager on him, but just a small one, but definitely the exact I'll do. But the first horse I'll talk about is the 3 horse Elegant Escape. Gets the leg up of Tom O'Brien on this one, the 6-year-old gelding by Dubai Destination. Colin Tizard trains this one. This horse's most recent outing came the 1st of December at Newbury, 3 miles and 1/4 in the Grade 3 Ladbrokes Trophy Chase. He finished second by 10 lengths behind Sizing Tennessee, who ran a monster race. But this horse, he jumped well, stayed the distance. He ran a decent effort there. Before that, the 11th of November at Sandown, 3 miles in a listed chase, he won by a half length there, and he just did everything right. Jumped well, easy walk in the park. And then the Grade 1 Betway Mid-May Novices Chase, it's Aintree last April, 3 miles and 1/8. He finished third by 13 lengths. You know, Aintree can be a fair course at times, but sometimes horses don't handle it. This horse just did not get around the race course well. Owlbear, and then I shell them in the RSA insurance Snubs Chase back during the festival last March. He finished third by 14 lengths, and he was closing up well, but it was just a little bit too late in the race. And then before that, X-Turn, a graduation chase horse, won by 13 lengths, very easy race. I think he's going to stay the distance of ground. I think he has a good weight here, and I think he's going to really run well. His last one was very promising, so I'll use him here as a horse in my Exactor forecast, along with the 5-horse Vintage Clouds. This horse, he's 8-1, but like I said, he's trading at somewhere 9.5-1 in the UK markets. Danny Cook's on this one for Sue Smith, this 8-year-old gelding by Cloudings here. This horse's most recent outing came the 24th of November at Haydock, 3 miles and 3/16 in Class 2 handicap chase. Back to a handicap for the first time in God knows when. The horse won by a half length, and at 7-2, he just jumped well and destroyed the field. Well, didn't destroy it. He jumped well there. It wasn't the most impressive victories, but he got the job done there first off the break. Before that, he ran on air on the 21st of April, 4 miles in the Grade 3 Scottish Grand National, where he finished third by 4 lengths, and he jumped well a little bit early on, but then he just kind of went backwards. At the end, wasn't the day to win. And then before then, the Grade 3 Ultima Handicap Chase of Cheltenham, 3 miles, 1/8, March 13th. He finished third by 6.25 lengths, and he just weakened out of it going up the hill. Didn't jump the last few well. And then he ran this race last year. Like I said, this race was run in early January last year, or actually earlier this year, 3 miles and 11/16, where he finished fourth by 17 lengths. And, he was excelling a little bit at the end as a 7-1 favorite, but the ground was a sludgy going, and I just don't think he really liked it. I think today with the drier ground, he should do well, and 8-1, I'll give him a chance. I think he'd get redemption for last year's run. So to recap my selection for the 5th, the 250 from Chep Stow, it's the Grade 3 Welsh Grand National. Gonna use the 3-horse Elegant Escape. I'll also use the 5-horse Vintage Clouds. Like I said, depending on the odds, I might do an each way on both of them, but I'm definitely gonna do a 3-5 Exacto forecast box here. So good luck to all. Please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5.